Hi, I'm Josh Kaplan, Senior Program Manager for Azure Analysis Services. Today we're going to talk about enterprise data warehousing in the cloud and how you can achieve this with Azure SQL Data Warehouse and Azure Analysis Services. Before we get into the details, let's take a look at this in action with a quick demo. So what you see here is the Power BI desktop connected to an Azure Analysis Services model. The data in that model shows data from trips from New York City taxi cabs. Now we have information on every trip, when a customer was picked up, how long the trip was, where they were dropped off at. So if I want to know something as simple as just how many trips were there in this time period, all I need to do is go to the trips table and find the trip count measure. And I can just drag that onto here. And what this is going to do is actually run a query and count all the rows that are in our trips table inside of our data warehouse. Now what it did here is it scanned that data and you'll see that it returned just over 2 billion rows. And it did that in a fraction of a second. The way it was able to do that was by it actually scanned the data in memory in our cache rather than going all the way back to the data warehouse. Now, when the data is this fast, you can start to ask more questions of it. So let's look at actually where all these trips are occurring. I'm going to add our pickup latitude and our pickup longitude, and we'll look at this by revenue. And you can see there are lots of trips in New York, as to be expected. And we've just plotted them on a map. Every time I clicked there, it actually went and ran queries back against Analysis Services and returned the results. And you can see it's a lot of results. So let's actually do analysis. If I was a cab driver, where would be the best place for me to go pick up my customers? So let's look at the revenue per trip, how much money I can make per trip. And we'll look at it by the top 10 pickup locations by zip code. Again, this just ran additional queries out to Analysis Services and return the results back. And we can see two big locations stand out in New York. If I want to know what they are, I can click the first one and actually filter down the other two visuals on the report. And you'll see the first zip code is actually JFK Airport. To be expected. You need a lot of taxis from the airport. And the second one is LaGuardia Airport, as there's two airports in New York. It gets so popular, you have to line up on the highway to get your rides. So looking at this, I can tell that I will get more revenue per trip if I go to JFK rather than going to LaGuardia. However, where can I get more trips? Where, if I'm a cab driver, should I go to make the most money I can in a day? So let's look at the actual number per trips. Put our trip count back on here. And let's slice this by the average duration of each trip. We'll make some room here so we can fit it on our screen. I want to use a little trick here in Power BI that lets me change how the visuals interact with each other. So I'm going to make it so when I click on something here, it actually filters this visual down rather than slicing it. So now when I click on JFK, I only see trips for JFK. And you can see most of the trips from JFK are 30 to 45 minutes. And JFK is kind of far from downtown, so that's kind of understandable. If we look at LaGuardia, however, you can see the vast majority of the trips are just 15 to 30 minutes. Now, the revenue per trip is still pretty similar. I think they have some flat rates in New York. So while you can make more money per trip at JFK, you can actually do way more trips if you pick up customers at LaGuardia. So this is a quick example of how we can do querying on top of large amounts of data from data that was collected in SQL Data Warehouse and then processed into Azure Analysis Services. And we can do this very, very quickly. Now you've seen the demo, let's look at how we built it. We collected data from thousands of taxi cabs in New York City, and we've loaded it to an Azure SQL data warehouse. Now that data warehouse is optimized for loading the data and transforming it. In order to give our business users access to that data, we then built a semantic model on top of it using Azure Analysis Services and processed that data in memory. We used Azure Functions to coordinate the processing of the new data as it arrives. Then we can connect to it with Power BI or other tools. Now, why do we build the semantic model instead of just letting the users connect directly to the data sources? We could just as easily connect Power BI or Excel or other tools to Azure SQL Data Warehouse and use a query from there. However, a data warehouse is not usually optimized for business users to be connecting directly to it. It's optimized for data load and data storage and doesn't usually handle lots and lots of different queries being thrown at it. So to make it easier for our business users to query that data without having to know which tables to join on and which filters to apply, we build the semantic model layer with Analysis Services in the middle, which contains all this information. In addition to that, we also cache the data in memory in our in-memory column store engine so that when queries come in, they're actually intercepted by analysis services and answered out of memory, rather than having to be sent back to the data warehouse. This means that your data warehouse does not have to be scaled up to handle every single query that comes in. And after it's been transformed and loaded into analysis services, you can actually pause that data warehouse or scale it back down to save money. To learn more about Azure Analysis Services or SQL Data Warehouse, please check out the following links on azure.com. Thank you for watching this video.